young child. She kept the secret and the pain to herself.
I was scared of the dark, these dreams, and I could hear somebody running or something, and he'd come in if I didn't wake him. After a while, I just kind of, when he'd take me into the room, it would kind of be like I was stepping outside of me.
Marie, we have just bought our new camera, and we decided we'd start out the tape by taking a picture of the house. We live right on the lake. As you can see, we got a two-story house. It's a good-looking house. There's the street. We live on a secondary road just along by the lake, so it's actually a dead-end street. It's a very nice place to live. It's a nice place about it, we're right on the lake. Of course, the day is not very good. It's been cold for the last month, about 18 above today and lots of clouds. However, we should get some warm weather by next month. Just about the time we're ready to head to Grand Manan. You can see we got some ducks on the lake, quite a few young ones. I believe these are mallards. Lots of young ones around this year. This is our house from the lakeside. I'm sitting right on the lake now, right on the lake shore. You can see we've got a lot of patio. A real comfortable house. This is looking over at the next door neighbors. This is taken from our front lawn right on the lake. It's a fair-sized lake. It's about 5 kilometers long, about 3 kilometers wide. And you can see it's quite a cloudy day out. Here I'm looking at now, you can't quite see it, but off in the distance there's you can see a house just through the trees, and that's where Jerry and Leslie live. Yeah, about 10 minutes walk across the lake during the winter time. Maybe 15 minutes around the lake. They got a nice home there. We have some ducks out in the lake right now. Mostly mallards. A lot of canada geese around, but they're not at this particular time. We'll get pictures of them if they do show up before we go to Grand Manan. Now in the living room, taking a picture out of our living room window, looking right over the lake again. Hope I can get it all in.
You've seen the way Miles looks when you tell those St. Olaf stories.
That's a mirror on the far wall, hallway looking down to the bedrooms and the bathroom. And their fireplace. Pretty hard to get a good picture and get it all in. River kitchen. Looking out to the roadside, the house. See if I can get it in to get the roadside outside. Here, a picture going through the window there. Picture of our front porch and of course the rest of the kitchen. There's Phil standing there sneaking around the corner there. Biden. Patio looking back out towards the lakeside. As you can see, it is a big patio. There's a picture of our cat. We always had to get cat in on it. Not very friendly, but a very good cat. The picture from our bedroom window. A motorboat coming along. You can see there's a lot of clouds in the sky. It's still a beautiful day out. About 25. Say hello, Sam. Hey, Sam.
That was some pictures of me and Sam. Guess what? I told them I was going to take a picture of him, so he gave me the...
Yeah, you have to shut up. That's the picture of the water.
Say hello, Mom.
Hello.
Lander Lake. Hey, Sam. Hey, Sam. Hello, Sam. Sam. Kathy, what do you think of Jerry's new outfit? That's his Grand Manan outfit. Say hello, Sam. Kathy, I had to show you this boat. Wish you were here. It's time to charge the battery up.
Is it running down?
Yeah. Hey, Sam.
That's full. Ice cream and strawberries. They're good. I'll give you some in the bowl to take home. Oh, wait to Auntie Kathy.
Tell Auntie Kathy had a good supper. We had a feast.
Hello, Sam. Wave goodbye.
This is our Canada Day picnic.
Wave goodbye.
Wave, Sam.
Sam threw up.
Yeah. He celebrated.
Grandpa got it. Part of it, didn't he?
Wave, Sam. Wave
he
goodbye. Wave, Dustin.
Wave, Dustin. Hi, Annika. Hi, Shane. Wave to your cousin.
You got some supper at home, last
night. Hey,
cousin Shane. Mm-hmm.
or just a closer walk with me?
Smile, Mark. Hi, David.
Thank you. song is equal to song.
It looks like it. Yeah.
Well, worth it though.
Is there a lot of summer homes or are they all permanent homes?
Yeah. A lot of permanent homes. So. Yeah. Yeah. You come up to the Y Road, you see a lot of houses up there. Quite close. Hi, babe. How are you doing?
I never have one. Oh, really? I really had great. Yes, I should. It is so. Sir, catch me yelling at my
child. Smile for the camera.
Move it.
Ed, Karen, say hello for the camera. There you are.
Say hello to the camera.
Say hello, Mom.
No, Mommy.
Ed, say hello, Mom.
Hello, Mother. How are you doing?
I could have. But I did mention to her something about...
Yeah, well, that's true.
Yeah.
Darn near. He was there to there.
Alana, I don't want you in the drink. In the lake.
Yep.
I thought you would take a place.
You're kidding. I don't know.
Looks like Angie.
How could you take those home though, Ed? So
right,
she can
them?
See it.
Right. Whose cat?
Oh, that was my...
That is my mother.
After Mom and me, we had live chickens in those sacks.
Oh, now that's... Really?
Let me see.
Like a picture of it out of my mom's my sister and my me with the little
marked
head. Same
there.
Suspended.
Tara, get your butt up here!
I need to get in.
Because
I have a okay, get in there and I can
if I would have asked you sooner, I would come here. Yeah. I don't want you to Tara and Echo.
There's a smell.
Come on, Alana. Come get cigarettes,
yeah.
No, but I need you up here.
Bye.
Bye.
Ow!
Oh, no. Yeah, we got it recording it anyhow.
Wish you were here. Yeah.
Yeah. I don't know how good it's going to be.
Are we being recorded now?
Yeah, you've been recorded.
Oh, well, we have.
You want to get up there close, Bill? Get your picture taken? Yeah, and this is Grand Prix, Nova Scotia, just outside of Wolfville, on our way to Digby. Home of Evangeline. Well, Phil. Trying to get a picture now of Cape Blommenden. Blommenden, Phil?
Blommenden.
Blommenden, yeah. far away, it's a bad day. Well, I get it. Let's see if I can get one more. Oh, I've had a recording all along. Tell them this is just a small short run of Digby, Nova Scotia, taken from the windows of the Fine Resort for the ferry to come. Hello, Sam.
Hello, Sam.
Watch Dad's beer dust.
Grandma, I got you. Say hi.
Hello.
Here's Dustin. Got Dustin, too.
Happy holiday.
Got Danny and Leslie.
Am I on here?
Yeah. Happy holidays, Les.
Happy holidays. Video
no,
camera.
Don't rip your teeth.
Hello, Sam.
Hello.
Where'd your butt come from?
Hello. Frank, Dustin.
Here,
Dustin, get over
and see
Grandpa.
Sit on my knee. We'll
get you up there.
Thank you.
Get your picture
turn
taken.
Around there and look at the camera.
Forever and a day.
Ooh, let's smile for her.
Cheese!
That's right on. There, we got you. Right in there. Great. Okay.
Is that little Alice's?
No, this is Aunt Alice.
Alice Louise.
Alice Brewster.
Julia.
8 years old. And Julia Brewster, 6 months old.
Yeah.
Now, who's this? Who was Warren Worcester?
Well, Warren Worcester was Sam Worcester's father.
Oh, my soul, babe, that's an antique for sure. Yeah. Good grief.
See, he was married first. I think his first wife died, and then she married Henrietta.
Goodness sakes, well, I found these in some pictures
that Mom had. Was that Aunt Henny?
Huh?
Was that Aunt Henny?
Yeah.
And that's Alice O'Malley.
Well, first of all, Sam, these are Alice.
Across the eyes, kind of.
This is the lake by our place. Now it's all grassed in. But that's the summertime, and that's the winter.
Oh.
Do you know who that is? You know Betty Brown? Well, that's Betty and me.
Oh, yes, you can tell.
One summer, I came down, and I don't know, they were Browns. They lived down here somewhere.
Wow.
What Browns they were. They were quite young, so.
The Johns girls?
Yeah.
Well, John.
Well, you probably.
Well, that's who I mean, Dad. That looks like the Edna, you know, for what she looks
and
like.
And then there's another one in the mountain.
But then,
too,
no, there's a little boy. This is a boy. That's going to be.
It's a young boy.
It looks like Keith, but
that sounds good.
Well, it does. It looks like Keith.
Yeah.
Let me see.
Now, isn't that some glad person?
I love pictures.
Oh. There's, who's that? You know,
that was Mary.
Yeah, that's Mary. Now, look at this one. Won't she die when I show her that?
Oh, my word, who's that?
That's Mary.
Is
I
it?
Remember when Dot took that picture, we hung a blanket on the clothesline and stood her up. Stark naked,
oh,
she is.
My. <That's>,
Now, do you know who that is?
Is someone behind her holding her up? Must be.
Oh, I think that's Dot behind there. We hung the blanket up on the post.
There you go.
That is Aunt Alice, and that's Bobby, and I don't know who that is.
That's
really
Bobby?
I think that's Bobby.
Really?
Maybe that's one of her
grandkids.
And that's me and Aunt Henny, what they help my mother, so the story goes.
Look, that crib's.
And look at this one, Sandra. Isn't that too precious?
It's from 1946.
Ash, yes. We thought he was in the house, and that's what, maybe you went with Jerry.
This
and
is
we decided to go over and look, and just see you were coming out. And you came home. So we thought
this
he was in there late
on the spring, but now we've grown grass out here.
Yeah,
that's our neighbor.
Yeah,
that is. Oh, but that's what it's like.
No, you're staying, Dustin.
There's
a sorry.
Home saw up in here.
Come on.
And then Herb took it down and went to the right. Look at that.
No, I'm talking good night.
How far
does
he
live
from you?
Who's this, Grandpa? Frank? He lives about 75 miles.
That's not too bad.
No. We don't get out there. Oh, there's Dad again. We got to get a hold of that camera and get him on. And when it was worse,
this is a picture of our cabin. Second day at Graham and Ann. Jerry's dad's staying there, and Leslie and Jerry are staying up at the far one. Leslie, Jerry, Dustin, and Sam are staying here. Taking a view across the water to Wood Island.
So darn high now.
Now you got a smile.
Firm up a little. Sam's ready.
I wouldn't know where to start. Come on, Sam. No numbs for washing your hands.
Fell down when boom, didn't
get
you?
A picture of those lobsters there, Herb.
Yeah.
Well, I'm going to get a picture of
that.
Yo, take a tape of the lobsters, Grandpa.
Yeah.
Yeah.
She's feel like a Hollywood, you know, you turn cameras going.
I'll get a still photo. I should have. And then some more rolls, I guess.
Uh-oh, I'm not going to eat those.
You're not?
No, it looks good.
They taste a lot better than they look.
Hey, yo,
where do you think your mom
is? Where's the kids' table?
Mom and Dad? Do you sit beside Mom and Dad? Or they can help you with the lobsters?
Have to sit with you?
No!
We got two lobsters for the three kids. We didn't figure
he's singing. He's on the
radio. What's he doing? Hey, I see you there, Sandra.
He can spin his face or a snipe here.
Okay, there, now you can see me. This is what's left.
She's telling about going in the morning. You might try and make up your mind. She's going.
What? See
find it cool?
No, I just want to go there, but I don't want to go up there with
you. Oh. Thank you.
Grandpa. Hi.
Hi.
And Mom?
No. Hey, Chase, take a picture of the nice, beautiful ocean.
Sam.
What you got, Herb?
They get this closed off, Ray? Ray, have they got this closed off? Huh?
Yeah.
Get it!
to her face?
Yeah, yeah. Six big lobsters, fresh right from the Atlantic Ocean. You're gonna hold one of these creatures up.
A blanket on his back.
A little too hot, get the handle. Nice and warm. Beautiful look. Hey, Sam. Nan. Oh, got Sam on video. Smile, Sam. Hello, Sam. Hi, Sam. Say hello, Sam. What? Say hi, Sam. Look at rocks. Look at rocks. Rocks. Rocks.
But look, it was in the whole box.
Mm-hmm.
baby's tummy? Which one? Which one? Which one's he?
Stag. He's in here with us.
Where is the stag? Is he not around?
Getting new buckets.
Where's the stag? Is he in there with
us? No, he's down with the other.
Sam, you can't get off.
Oh, look at they're fighting.
He's trembling.
Is he?
Yeah, he's down.
Oh, no, he can't go. No. Oh, look at the little one.
Dustin? There you are. We're looking in the wrong place all the time.
Worcester, who was my Annie Catherine's first husband, and Samuel was the father of my mother and my Aunt Alice, who lives in Boston. And Samuel died when Mother was 11 months old. And on this side, he was
and he's your great-grandfather, this one.
He's my great-grandfather.
Oh, okay.
Here's a Julia. Julia A. was Worcester, who was the first wife, I believe, of James Warren. And my mother always told me that there was always a Julia in every generation down through the family. And we have kind of kept that going in little Julie in our family. Okay, these are the graves of my grandmother, Annie Catherine's grandparents, who raised them on Southern Head Light because, no, now I think I'm wrong, Debbie. Now you helped to help me.
Okay, Albury, I believe, died when your grandmother, Annie Catherine, was just a small child. And then Alice died at the age of 24 shortly after. And they were raised by the grandparents, Walter Butler McLaughlin, and his wife, Clorinda, down in Southern Maine.
Okay.
Formal.
Yeah. All right, you can tell this part.
These are the parents of Alvery McLaughlin, Walter Butler McLaughlin, who was born in 1829, died in 1906, and his wife Clorinda Wermel, who was born in 1865, died in 35, and died in 1907. Married Sam Worcester and George Russell.
Yeah, this is where the Butler comes in.
Yes. Walter, Walter Butler McLaughlin's mother was Catherine Butler, who came, I believe, from Ireland. And the father was Daniel McLaughlin, who, as the tombstone says, was a soldier of Waterloo. And he was the first...
I can get this in. Where it says he...
Yeah, a soldier of Waterloo. He would have only been 20 years old, because the Battle of Waterloo was in 1814, was it not?
It died in 1862. Soldier of Waterloo.
An honest man is the noblest work of God.
Isn't that marvelous?
I like the quote on her stone, too.
She hath done and called her blessed. Her children arise and rise up.
The name of the book is for the Glory of the Seas.
Glory of,
And his.
But he's no direct descendant.
No, he'd be an uncle. But I love that stone. And you know, he lived in California. After he retired for a number of years, his descendants live in California, and one of them was here a few years ago doing some research, I believe, on another book. But both wives sailed around with him. Margaret was a Gatcombe, and she had married a Benson, who was a sea captain and who was murdered.
This is Phil's home where she was born. And this house over here is where Ann Hilda lived. The first church. It's 127 years old. In Grand Harbor, Grand Manan. This is the oldest, one of the oldest cemeteries in town. This is a house in Seal Cove where Nan was born. It used to be a grocery store. Now a restaurant. Thank you.
Wave. Wave, Sam. Wave. Wave at Grandpa. Wave. Say hello, Aunt Kathy.
Hello, Aunt Kathy.
And Uncle Mike.
Uncle Mike.
Shane and Gavin.
Shane and Gavin.
Yeah, you wave, Dust. Wave, Shane. My Lord, wave, Sam. Sam? Hey, Sam, wave. Hello, Sam.
I can't really see anybody here, but believe it or not, in this car there's people going on an excellent rain-soaked thundercloud adventure. Downtown Toronto. Bit of a show going on today. There's Phil and everybody walking around. We're at City Center, Toronto. Give you a panoramic view. Comedy day here, and they do all kinds of weird stuff. Get a little out of hand here. Here come the other. Must be the city smog. There we go.
Record on the screen?
Yeah, we're downtown Toronto.
Someone just knocked all their tomatoes over on the floor there.
Where?
You're not supposed to, and you're going to be followed for the rest of your life. No, Julie.
That's where the tomato scene took place.
Yeah, you press on the very back button in the top where your top fingers are, and it'll make it zoom backwards. This is Spadina. Now, this is China. We're going to go right, actually.
Look at this one, Kath. Did you get that store there?
We're going to try.
It's very difficult to do this.
Yeah, too bad. All you want.
You want lettuce? I could run out and grab a little lettuce.
You buy high end of them here. They just open up their stores and move it right onto the streets. But it's good for the tourists, you know.
Oh,
lots of people buy, lots of people buy. And if we ever make a right turn here, it'll be a miracle.
Yeah.
Yeah, they got an ambulance in the
right
there, right? Straight ahead,
Mike. What?
Straight ahead,
lights are flashing.
Here.
Straight up the street.
Sorry.
I see it!
Here comes the ambulance.
Where is
another
it?
Another shooting
behind
here.
Us?
Someone's
yeah,
dead.
Another murder. Another murder.
Three guys got murdered here the other night.
There's a missing person sign, Kathy.
Yeah, got it.
Okay, now this is...
Well, some of these little shops are going to be really neat to go in.
This is fun to travel, but I don't wouldn't like to bring the kids down to this part. Just
no.
Because it's...
My seatbelt's tight.
The lost one you'd never...
Oh, sure. Mommy.
Mommy.
Mommy. Oh,
I
never knew anything like this existed, Mike.
Oh, yeah. A lot of fun, actually.
Standing up. He's sitting down would be better.
No. Have your seatbelt on.
Okay, I want you to go sit down in the back for me. Look at the bumps in it. You're driving in the streets where it's terrible. Now look to the left here. That's part of the Spadina market in there. They got all kinds of stuff and you've into it, but I'd rather not. Just because if you get into it,
no, that's okay.
No, we're just
can view from a distance.
See what we're seeing.
Right down there on the left, in there.
Down there.
That's where it all is in there.
Yeah.
Really gets going. But that's pretty well it. We're almost out of it now. But we'll go up and come around, and I'll take.
Shane Connor.
You be good and stay there, please.
Chickens and something.
Chickens and a small rodent.
A large rodent. Rat. Michael swept it up in the back of his sweeper the other day. Sold it for a couple bucks.
You've been going for the crowds here, Kathy, down here for the crowds. And look at the crowd. This is the modern ball here on the right.
I want a teddy bear cookie.
Okay, wait a while.
But that's pretty well Chinatown. We're out of Chinatown now and heading our way down to normal suburbia, I guess. I guess there's nothing normal about this area. But Queen Street is pretty wild on the left coming up here.
I want two.
There's not much use to filming anymore down here, Kat. There's nothing spectacular. Who's asleep? Is Julie asleep?
No.
Kids. Queen Street there, that's where all the young kids go. At nighttime, all the different bars and everything else.
Where's that?
I've been this muffins, etc.
Kathy, turn that thing off.
There's the actual downtown core. To the left, we got the CN Tower right to the top and back down. And there's the top of the dome. And goes off the infamous Gardiner Expressway. And here's a couple of tourists just kind of looking up. Phyllis! And there we go, waving, and Bev. This is Lake Ontario. They got the old gondola rides now. Panning to the right to see the boats. Center Island in the front there. There's a big tall ship way down there. Going away from us. Just right here. You can see the big boat here, that's the HMC Protector. It's in the harbor to a Goodwill mission after going to the Persian Gulf. And here's the harbor, all the boats. It's
getting windy because we're due for a big storm. A lot of nice boats. Once again, the CN Tower way in the background there. Too high for any camera to fit. Kathy's favorite boat is right over there, that blue one. Solid wood, it's beautiful. Just barely see it. Boat going out, beautiful boats. The airplane landing. To heck with it, they're called the Wizard North. It's a Chinese junk and you can rent it. Around here. So, man-made bay with a couple of bars, places to eat. Oh, who's this pretty girl? Who's this good-looking guy? Get there out of the way there. Hi, Gavin. There's Phil and Bev again. Stuck to each other like glue. Gavin's happy, as you can tell. For the turkeys, they pond up and found a big, much dangerouser slide, and they're ready for action. And the end result? Shane Asper has found himself some rocks. And off they go again. Oh, here's another turkey.
Oh, how about that?
Come on, Julie.
Oh. Did anybody see that? I'll do that again.
What are you doing that for?
Getting in our house.
Total waste of film. Okay, let's go. Unload.
That's our neighbors.
Shane is asleep, so keep the monster under control.
Once again. In case she didn't get any of that.
Wow. Haley, can you hear us?